And now the end is near, and so I face the final curtain. My friend, I'll say it clear, I'll state my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full, I traveled each and every highway and more, much more than this. I did it my way. Regrets, I've had a few, but then again, too few to mention. I did what I had to do and saw it through without exemption. I planned each charted course, each careful step along the byway, and more, much more than this, I did it my I'm sure you knew, when I bit off more than I could chew. But through it all, when there was doubt, I ate it up and spit it out. I faced it all and I stood tall and did it my way. I've had my fill, my share of losing, and now, as tears subside, I find it all so amusing to think I did all that, and may I say, not in a shy way. Oh no, oh no, not me. I did it my way. For what is a man? What has he got? If not himself, then he has not.
I'm certain.
I've lived a life that's full. I traveled each and every highway and more, much more than this. I did it my way. Regrets, I've had a few, but then again, too few to mention. I did what I had to do and saw it through without exemption. I planned each charted course, each careful step along the byway, and more, much more than this, I did it my way. Yes, there were times, I'm sure you knew, when I bit off more than I could chew. But through it all, when there was doubt, I ate it up and spit it out. I faced it all and I stood tall and did it my way. I've loved, I've laughed and cried, I've had my fill, my share of losing, and now, as tears subside, I find it all so amusing to think I did all that, and may I say, not in a shy way. Oh no, oh no, not me. I did it my way. For what is a man? What has he got? If not himself, then he has not.
My way.
regrets. I've had a few, but then again, too few to mention. I did what I had to do, saw it through without exemption. I planned each charted course, each careful step along the byway, and more, much more than this, I did it my way. Yes, there were times, I'm sure you knew, when I bit off more than I could chew. But through it all, when there was doubt, I ate it up and spit it out. I faced it all and I stood tall and did it my way. I've loved, I've laughed and cried, I've had my fill, my share of losing, and now, as tears subside, I find it all so amusing to think I did all that, and may I say, not in a shy way. Oh no, oh no, not me. I did it my way. For what is a man? What has he got? If not himself, then he has not.
I'm certain I've lived a life that's full. I traveled each and every highway and more, much more than this, I did it my way. Regrets I've had a few, but then again, too few to mention. I did what I had to do, saw it through without exemption. I planned each charted course, each careful step along the byway, and more, much more than this, I did it my way. Yes, there were times, I'm sure you knew, when I bit off more than I could chew. But through it all, when there was doubt, I ate it up and spit it out. I faced it all and I stood tall and did it my way. I've loved, I've laughed and cried, I've had my fill, my share of losing, and now, as tears subside, I find it all so amusing to think I did all that, and may I say, not in a shy way. Oh no, oh no, not me. I did it my way. For what is a man? What has he got? If not himself,
did it my way.
off more than I could chew. But through it all, when there was doubt, I ate it up and spit it out. I faced it all and I stood tall and did it my way. I've loved, I've laughed and cried, I've had my fill, my share of losing, and now, as tears subside, I find it all so amusing to think I did all that, and may I say, not in a shy way. Oh no, oh no, not me. I did it my way. For what is a man? What has he got? If not himself, then he has not.
Look at that, it's supposed to be forward some more. Look at that. Yeah. I'm going to
All right, guys, good morning, teacher, everyone. Everybody comments in the next few minutes. Just like to give the family request, and they are saying that you can view the body, but there are no pictures. Please, no pictures. Please, no pictures. Okay? I make myself clear? Simple as that, right? No pictures of him in the casket. If you didn't take him while he's alive, don't take him while he's dead. Simple as that. Alright? Yeah. So we're going to start in the next few minutes or two. Any question from the blog benefits, we can start.
Okay.
This service. Keep on your masks. If you're looking for water to wash your hands, remember right there. My audience is, you're a private people. Yeah, you're a private. My audience is that way. You're a private. You're in a private members club. But then again, I've got more to attend, so I come over here. Alright. Hurry up. Hey, our program, Lord.
Yeah, our program.
What are you, too?
I want to go back.
on instructions, you can view the body at a time if you want to. But during the time of time, you can view the body. So as we start, we'll close it back, the casket soon.
Short for you, but yeah. Everybody has 2 minutes. But we're open. But I know you know more than anybody else.
Yes, it's true. It's true.
Yeah.
It's true.
I respect that.
Yes, yes.
Son? Yeah. You can open in prayer. Mm-hmm. I just get out 2 minutes to say something right after.
Okay. I'm going to pray. I'm going to pray.
You open in prayer.
Right.
And while you open in prayer, mm-hmm. you just say it, you know, 2 minutes speech
yeah.
right after. So you wouldn't be able to call again. Okay. You understand? Okay. So I'll make the announcement.
Oh, okay.
Make it easy. Yeah. Anybody ever 6 feet got wrong?
Not yet. Not me. I'm home there. I get up.
Wait. Are you cute?
Yeah, we have it.
I want that to start. I want somebody to see the next mic.
Yeah.
Oh, you get through? Yeah. That's all I wanted this song. Think I'm not poor. No battery. Check, check. This one too. Check. This number see?
Okay,
but
two.
That draw is off. Let me see.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God, we give you praise.
How are you?
Yeah, ma'am. Accord?
Yeah.
Yeah, I got accord, Michael, some kind of thing, but we ain't get out of the...
All right.
What I do is sad by time. Something.
Without exemption.
So we want to continue. However, for the interest of time, there is somebody who is well known in the community and a servant of God, and just ask him to come and with us in prayer. And after that, I'll go. And then he will follow suit right after. No other person, Mr. We all know him as Father, and I trust most people know him as Father, so Mr. George. So we ask him to give his tribute at the same time. And right after that, we have the scripture reading. And we have songs of worship by Mr. Marvin Felix. And let's follow the program, all right? So good morning to each and everyone.
Well, let's say nothing. Say something.
Good morning to each and everyone. We are glad to celebrate the life of our well-known friend, father, grandfather, in the community, in the person of Mr. Thomas Garcia. As we are about to commence, we call on Father to open us in prayer and give us tribute at the same time. Thank you.
A pleasant good morning to everybody. We are here on a very solemn occasion. And I've been asked to offer a word of prayer for the congregation, not for the dead, but for the dead. Heavenly Father, our God, be pleased, Almighty God, to be present here with us this day. It is a time, my God, that none of us take delight in the departing of a loved one. But I give you thanks, Almighty God, that there is hope beyond the grave. There is the resurrection of life for those that live right upon this earth. Therefore, I give you thanks and praise you and bless you. For this gentleman and myself was good friends. We good friends. We worked together for over 40 years. Many years. And Lord, I don't know his voice, you know it, but my testimony this day to the audience that come to be aware that he was a good man and loved his children. And I give thanks for the privilege of being here this morning to pray for his children. His sons, O Lord, and his son's sons and the mother is not yet there. And I ask you, Lord, to keep the family that is leaving behind in one accord. Let love be the hallmark that will bind them together. And as thou will keep us to alive along with them, I am willing myself, my God, to play any part in their lives as they would request by your strength. And I thank you, Lord Jesus. I thank you, I praise and I bless you. But at this time, Lord, you come to this small audience and pass, lift your hands above the heads of all who are here. In Kobe Road, my God, in Vigo Martin, there's so much killing of young men, killing each other, Jesus. I ask you, Lord, to speak to the minds of the parents in this village. that they would educate their children right, my God. Not the prison, not the gun, not the cocaine, but to love one another. Spirit of God, I thank you, and I bring this nation before you, to the dying and to the dead. That cloud is over this country, Jesus. But I know, Lord, that you can move this cloud, and you could. And you could move this cloud. I have made a commitment to you in this land. Whatsoever I could be used by you to do, I will do it for the glory of your eternal name. And I thank you for hearing me.
Yes.
And for answering. Amen.
Amen.
And amen. I am asked to say something, and I know that 2 minutes would. Mr. Thomas Gass and I began to work in the Ministry of Works as children, young people. I was a teenager, and he was just that. And we worked together for almost 140 years. A rude boy could have a child and a grandchild there. Any rude boy. A 40-year-old man could have that. And what I remember of him most of all, I remember the government that sent us to work in Malawi, he and I, to teach the men in Malawi the trade to bark the sea and to protect this land, all the rivers and so that was my job. And because the people in Malawi loved us so much, they would have given us plenty of fish. They would have figured all the anchor in Malawi. And I remember Mr. Garcia and I eating this fish every day, eating this fish every day, eating this fish every day. And at night, he hit me and I heard him groaning. I got up, I went, and I see how I shook him. I see how pain is. Right? Come here. They came, and I took him to the clinic in my house. He's a strong man. This man is a strong man. Very strong man. A stone, they give it, they inject his spot. And the doctor sliced his spot and took out a stone in it. A stone was in his flesh. He didn't know that. Mr. Garcia. Every worker, every boss in the Ministry of Works had respected him. And I bear witness, he worked for his children. He labored, he had no Sabbath, no Sunday. He always, somewhere going to a job to work to bring food for his children. And I'm asking them today, I'm asking the children today, let the peace of Almighty God be in them. To remember the Father worked to protect them and provide for them. I bear witness to that. May God bless them. And may God bless you all. Thank you.
Thank you. God bless you. At this time, I want to call on one Makeda Garcia Clovis to come and do the scripture reading, which is his granddaughter, hard worker. Let's cheer on her as she comes.
Good morning, everyone. My scripture today is from John 14, verse
check
1 to 3.
Check one, two.
Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also.
This time I'm going to call on the worship team, Minister Marine Felix. And The team just come and worship, so just join with her. Normally we stand at this time and we join and we sing, so let's celebrate, amen? Amen. For those of you who have legs and can stand, stand. If you don't have legs and you just sit down, continue.
Good morning, everyone. Oh, we can do better than that. This is a life well lived. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. To God be the glory, great things he has done. If you think I came here to have a wake up, well, station. Hallelujah. Because we have to rejoice. Hallelujah. We don't have to sorrow like those that are poor, but he made his calling and election for. And so we are giving God praise and thanks. I pray greetings from Santa Cruz Deliverance Temple Pastor John Sibaran and the family that he. I did not know him as long as some of you, but I felt like I did. Hallelujah. When was my 60th birthday, I thought, well, Papi ain't coming again, and that's our name for him, right? And at 10 o'clock, the man presented himself in Santa Cruz. He couldn't miss that 60th birthday, and so I'm now 61. So I am grateful because he's not going to experience another birthday with me. So I'm thanking God. I tell him, I want to bat like you, you know. He said, girl, you see this thing, it's any easier, you know. And then he had to give you all his story. How many of us know when he began to talk? You need a happy day. Amen. I get a phone call all the time. So we need to rejoice. Hallelujah. He made it. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Oh, come on and just give him some praise. I don't care what church you belong to, just as long as for Jesus you stand. Put your hands together for soldier that made it home. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. If I could die on a pilgrim journey, heaven is my home. If I could die on a pilgrim journey, heaven is my home.
Hallelujah, glory be.
to God. Anybody have a special song that they want to hear right now? I don't want a dead one though. Hallelujah. I don't want to feel like I'm taking everything. So this be the last song. So you can shout it out. We going with it. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on and praise him. Daddy, you have one? Hallelujah. What's your song, Daddy? Nothing. Amen. Praise the Lord. Go ahead. Oh, Jehovah is the name. That's kind of slow. Yeah, mind if you sing it a little later? Alright, but we go to it. You know what? Jehovah is your name as a worship song. I'll leave that for Pastor Bernard to do for you. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. We give God praise and we give God thanks. I think my sister,
Won't it be a time
when we get over yonder? Won't it be a time when we get over? That's what you know, Lord. Won't it be a time when we get over yonder? Oh, won't it be a time? Won't it be a time when we get over yonder? Won't it be a time when we get over yonder? Won't it be a time when we get over yonder? Oh, won't it be a time? You got to sing and shout. Sing and shout, dance all around. When we get over yonder, we're gonna sing and shout, dance all around. When we get over yonder, sing and shout, dance all around. When we get over yonder, oh, won't it be a time? And having talk about time, you know that it's time now to bring back the preacher. Amen. Praise the name of Jesus.
I think we can do one more song.
Yes.
Well, what do you all say?
Watch any time.
Yeah, we all watch any time. We have about 1 hour from just start. Who said that? I'll be brave. I have any focus on, I'm going to make sure I turn the focus on. Thank God they watch my back. Let's do a song, Someday I'll Go Where Jesus.
Go ahead, sing it.
You brave. Hold the microphone, brother.
Let's go.
Someday.
Yeah.
Someday.
I'll go where Jesus. Someday.
Someday.
Someday. I'll go where Jesus. Someday. Someday. Someday.
I'll.
And I'll be caught up. So someday, hey, I'll go where? Someday. And I'll be caught up. I'll be caught up. Someday. We all will go. I'll go where Jesus. Someday. Say someday. And someday, say I'll go. And I'll be caught up. I'll be caught up to meet him. I'll be joy and say someday. I'll tell the how he caught up to meet him in the. So I am delivered, say. I am delivered, and I was lost in the valley of that. I am delivered. We are having church. I am delivered. I was lost in sin. So I am the way, but I am the way, but say, I am the way, but I am the way, but and I was lost and I was lost in sin in the valley. I am the way, but so someday, someday. Someday I'll go where? So someday, someday, and I'll go and I'll be caught up. Say, say, I'll be caught up and I'll be caught up. Up joy, joy, and say someday in glory. When the rose, when the rose is called up, sing when the rose is called up, say when the rose. Say when the roll is called up. So when the roll, when the roll, when the roll, say when the roll is called up. Say when the roll, when the roll is called up. Yeah, when the roll. When the roll, when the roll is called up, say when the roll, goodbye world, goodbye world. Goodbye. And I stay no longer with you. I made up my mind. I made up my mind. You hung it out already? So, goodbye world. I stay no longer with you. Goodbye world, goodbye world. I made up my mind. So goodbye world, goodbye world. I stay no longer with you and goodbye. I made up my mind. Say, I made up my mind. Say, so say, since I live. I feel better, so much,
so much better,
since I live, and I feel better, so since I live, so glory, 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 glory. Hallelujah,
this I live, my burdens.
glory, glory. Since I live. Let's put our hands together for the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We are having you here. Hallelujah. If you are alive, you can say praise the Lord. If you are alive, you can say praise the Lord. And if you are dead, you don't want to say anything.
Hallelujah.
And if you are alive, you can shout hallelujah. Yes, we are in church. We are in church. God is a good God. Hallelujah. The reason why I sing so much, because I know some of you cannot come and give a tribute, so I sing on your behalf, okay?
Amen. Praise the Lord.
So we have a little open floor tribute right now. So you may have your seats. Nice people. Keep it up. God bless you. Continue to wear your mask. Watch your distance as much as possible. And if you have any hand sanitizer, you can share with somebody who don't have, because our tanks are full and the pipe is not on. What's the destiny of the pump? So we want to have an open floor tribute at this time. And we ask people to come and give 2 minutes. Hear what I'm saying carefully. Those up there who cannot come down, I'm talking to you all here. You have 2 minutes to give a tribute of my time. 2 minutes. And if you go beyond that, I will pull the plug. Simple as that. All right? So the floor is open. You have 2 minutes. Who's going to come first? I want to give Preston an opportunity, but Preston, Father, talking about. Preston, take 2 minutes, sir. Please. Preston's a man who was with Mr. Garcia for years, always by him sitting down and chatting with Mr. Garcia. So I'm glad when I see him, brother. I'm glad. Your father, real child, boy. Go ahead.
A pleasant good morning to one and all. Well, I feel blessed to be home, home. And first to begin, I must say that Mr. Garcia has been a blessing to this community, a real, real blessing. That house, the house and all is a blessing. I would go into that house and he had a bookshelf with some encyclopedias. And the reason why I'm saying this is because what used to happen is that the block that we all grew up on, we must not only talk stupidness on the block.
Yeah.
And foolishness and totish talk. We must be able to leave the block, whether it's smoking weed or drinking whatever, and must be able to edify each other, because we don't know where we will end up from here. And we must be able to song as though we have sense. So inside that house there, it had a shelf full of encyclopedias. And I would, it's still there. Here now. But yeah, when you go in that house, it's troubling, you know, because you have to try and escape Mr. Gas, because you come to read, but he there. You know, and yes, he in himself is an encyclopedia.
Yes.
And it's 90 something years you're talking about. You know, so I spent some good days in that house with some good people. Yes, and it has been a blessing to know this gentleman, to spend time in that gallery there with him, and all the children. Listen, a man in Dunstan done back kick a ball straight in the baking a cake inside there, you know. And all the louvers in the cake, you know. And I come in here and I wonder, I'm trying to remember when I ever see Mr. Garcia vexed with anybody in this neighborhood. And I couldn't remember him in an argument with no one in this neighborhood. And that is what he represents. He represents care and love and oneness. And whenever you come to him, this cricket pitch here, when the idea came, he came from wherever, but anytime to do anything with young people and their development and good things, you will find him. And I heard my father said that he had no Sabbath. And I shoot, you know, Mr. Garcia going and work every time, whole day, full time. And if you want he and you to be friends, don't tell him to stop working, you know. Because when you resign, I thought he had done, you know. When you design, I say, right, it's like it's done. Then I see, going and build some shelf with all kind of material. I don't know, you sit down in the gallery and putting all kinds of together. I say, all right, well, that, because you walk in, I say, well, you go finish now. Then he tell me, because I want to change the roof. I say, see me, because I'm this house quick. So my friends, I don't want to take much more on time, but I could talk about that man and Melton, Shelton, Sean, and this whole crew, whole day, and the breakfast tree. So have a nice day, and I am here. Thank you.
You can't get it better than that. Anybody else?
I don't call anybody, you are free. I call the person because I know the person always there every day, you know, with him most of the time. Anybody else? You are free, the floor is open. Come quick. If you are coming, come. Thank you very much. Okay, good line up. Remember, it's 2 minutes?
Yeah, 2 minutes.
All right.
Good afternoon, everyone. So, I couldn't come here this evening and not say two ways. My name is Sebastian. From when he came to the world by my mom, I'm his second daughter, those of you who don't know me. And I literally remember just talking his ear off, and he's playing on the cars, and he's talking to him. Since then, I don't know if he, I think he knew it before, but since then, he has always made an effort to keep up with me, keep up with my journey. Of recent, when he learned WhatsApp, a day my phone is ringing, I'm like, Mr. Garcia. And I'm busy visiting my day, and I'm like, hi, Mr. Garcia, what's up? He's like, I just called to see how you're going. I'm like, I'm good. Him, don't take too much time, you know, I know you have to go back to your week. And those calls came quite often. And I think that is one of the things I would definitely miss, because those calls happen to come sometimes on one of the busiest of days, and it would help take you through the day. And one of the things he would always say to me when he called, Taxi, keep up, just calling to make sure that you're staying on the right path. I'm so proud of you, I'm so proud of your journey, mom, you worked so hard, and you keep doing your duty. And even recently when I spoke to him, he said he was really told me that he's really proud to see how far I've come. And I think I really, really appreciate him taking those moments to remind me of how far I've come and to encourage me, to share those encouraging words. And definitely would miss him. One of the things I love about, apart from my job, when he learned that I did cake, so for the 90th birthday, I did a cake for him. And he was adamant. Any birthday going forward, Taxi have to do the cake. And Makita would call, she had to be making sure Makita send the picture of him to do the cake for him. And it shows that he truly supported me in anything that I was doing. And I mean, yeah, I really, really, really appreciate it.
Hey, come in, come quick. She'll be running to the microphone. He lived 92 years. He ain't lived half the age of his life as yet. Run.
Good afternoon to the community. My name is Wallace. I was born to Reno de Montana. Mr. Lassa and me became very close. He was like my father. And not that me and my father are apart, but Mr. Lassa, every morning, as a rule, used to call to find out what you're doing, how you're going, what is your new plan for the day or tomorrow, what you have to do in the future. And he was always a driving force in this community with each and everybody. He might have touched somebody, parent, child, somebody in some way, he had some kind of advice or some piece of information that he had to give you to carry your own shoe. And I just want to say to the family, let me strong. Mr. Glass was a pillar in this community and he will always be remembered. And we will always look up there and be looking for him, because if they have a soul around here, could see Mr. Garcia for their life. So I just want everybody to be joyful. This is our sad time. Before you realize how hot the sun is. This is what you like to walk in. Hot sun. So right, he's smiling right now. We're glad to see the community coming together and everybody having a nice time to send them off. So everybody, good evening.
My dear Mr. Slide, 2 minutes.
All losses and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry every
one. I am Mr. Garcia's neighbor. I want to bless God for his family, his children, and I want to bless God for knowing Mr. Garcia. I have to shorten it because I call him the historian. Anything you want to know in Covinor, ask Mr. Garcia. When they wanted to do the little advertisement to find out the big old cave, Mr. Garcia knew. Who dead, Mr. Garcia knew. Who born, Mr. Garcia knew. And I want to bless God for that. But one thing you have for Mr. Garcia is, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God. And it comes from God. There's never a time you talk to him and he'll tell you about God. All the time I talk with him, no matter how I go in, I come out, whatever, to make sure that I continue. He said, this is the teaching from Adam to Lulu and all Adam's children. So you know what he did? He got me a concordance. And I have it in my gallery. You don't have to pay me. Because it's the Word of God we're talking about. And that's why I say, what a friend you have in Jesus. But I want to ask each and everyone, and everybody else here, to bless his children and his granddaughter. Because I've seen her throat and lift Mr. Garcia. We can bless her, you know. Only God can bless her. But pray for she and her husband. And I pray for his richest blessing. What a friend you have in Jesus. Oh, Lord, say that. I want to take out my comment.
You are gonna really know. Everyone we know. We're gonna go down, Mike. Hey, trouble here. We ain't finishing now, you know.
God is a good God, amen. That is one of my bigger sisters. Thank God for our younger one here also. And one of the things I love is that, and I appreciate it more so, is to hear Oba say that Mr. Garcia called him every day. Who in the world of that age calling some young person every day?
Yes, he
does. Who? Mr. Garcia? And then he called Betty Daughter to encourage her, she get a job. Who doing that? Mr. Garcia.
Yeah.
Then who taking time out to go and get a concordance of somebody to encourage them in the Word of God? Who doing that? And then you go by him and he have a whole book we had, everything on in our hands. He had it all piled up there. And those things, you buy them in stages. We who grew up in this community, you can't buy it at once because we don't have any kind of money. You have to save and buy, pay until you pay off for it. That man is a tremendous blessing. And sometimes we take these things for granted. And I'm gonna say this, and I'll be real now. Half of us here. All right, I'll be on social media. What I really want to say on social media, I'll take it on. I'm going to give Mr. Garcia. God bless you. I'm going to keep it straight as possible. Amen? Anybody else? I'll take him one more. I'll come quick, sweetie. You're so different.
Those of you who know me, we have a very powerful voice, even if you're not. For today though, it's a little bit lucky, but we are here to celebrate. I met Mr. Garcia 28 years ago when I began to work in Payless Hardware. He came in as a normal customer. He came in to buy, but he wasn't a normal customer because he had all the experience in the world.
How you going?
And I was now starting off. So he would come every day. Every day he came, I learned something. I learned about lumber, I learned. So I didn't really have to go anywhere to learn about materials because Mr. Garcia was a frequent customer with every knowledge in the world. Once you were willing to listen. As the years go by, we became closer and closer. Mr. Garcia started to work at my house. He would come to work with his youngest son. And some days, I would get to know his children, and he became like the father I didn't have. And as the years go by, as Katyan said, Mr. Garcia would call the hardware for nothing to see how we're going. But he would start with, I know you're busy, eh? But I just want to have a good day, you know. And then he would proceed, but he would call me every day. And then he went on social media and he learned WhatsApp, and it continued. But the thing is, he had a motivation. When Mr. Garcia, every time he would call with a project he wanted to do, the roof, they come in and I would say, it's time for you to relax. And he said, I will relax when I go to sleep. And in that 28 years, I don't have what that man did not do to that structure and other people's structure. And just as recent as about 2 years ago, I was doing a quote and I needed to know a mix for some cement. And I could have called Mr. Gas and he had it off his back. All right? So we really don't take the time to appreciate these people. I would leave and come up here and sit with them, and it's just so sad that young people do not take the time to embrace the elderly in their community and to gain so much from them. I would truly, truly miss Mr. Garcia, and I do pray Mr. Garcia wanted one thing, for his family to stay close. He would always tell me that that's all he wants, for his family to keep that bond. And I pray that that really continues, and I pray for Makeda, and I know God would bless her. Because I knew Mr. Garcia in good times and in bad times. And some of his best times was when that granddaughter came into his life. And I pray that God continues to bless her. Thank you.
Just a new strong.
So good morning, everyone. Some of you are going to have grown up, but those who know me.
Take off your mask, let's see your face.
Why do you want to see me?
Know who you are.
Go for a bit, girl.
She's gonna be there like every day with him. She.
No, that's his niece.
Oh, okay. Yeah, she's gonna be there regularly too.
Yeah, before that, mm-hmm. We were his. When they came, to the house, we were
I wish I could come and help the village, because that is how I grew up knowing him, Jason, and other people too. And it was a great pain for me when I actually got to the point of building and he couldn't help me. That was the most regretful thing in my life. But nothing happened before its time, and he was able to impart a lot of his knowledge. As the previous speaker would have said, you know, sometimes when I had something to do, most of the work I did by myself with my husband, and I would say, Uncle, what's the mixture for this cement again to do this thing? And he would go through the whole series of steps to me. And he would say, send me a picture when you finish, let me see how it looks. And, you know, he was really, really a fantastic
person.
And when my dad passed away, his brother, in 2015, I had taken him to the funeral. And they would have, they didn't go close, but, you know, he would always ask me, how your father going? And, you know, I would report to him how it is he was going and whatnot. And he just started to cry at the funeral. And I said, but Uncle, why are you crying? Your father wasn't so close. I say, feeling like the last man standing. And that came a running joke with us since that time. So I just want to pay tribute to the last man standing. I will miss you, miss you, miss you so much. Thank you.
Go quick, go quick.
Pleasant morning to everyone. Friends and relations and family condolences offer to them. I stood here and I hear the testimony of Mr. Garcia. I cannot say how long I know Mr. Garcia. I can say how long he knew me, which is over 60 years. He knew me as from a baby before I born. He knew my mom, my dad. My dad was his supervisor together with Mr. George. He has passed away. But one thing I want to add, Mr. Garcia is not just a stone man or a builder. I and him used to go fishing. And he said, pull up my maxi, yes, pack my maxi in the yard, and we'll go fishing. He loved fishing. And I remember when you clapped us out. When he clapped here, then he used to put on a tire, swollen. Mr. Garcia was a shoemaker. He put on my first swollen on my shoe, my clock shoe, when it was worn out. So, in all, he was a jack of all trades. And one thing, when he says something, when he's willing, and he says, you want a line, so you can tell him what you want. Right, so I just want to, people to appreciate, because we just have been learning a person in community and other people, a jack of all trades. And he loved all his children. Thank you.
All right, we have to give it to the end because father talk, president talk, and you come and talk now, that'll be kind of difficult. So we can't have father, you and president at the same time. No, sorry. Right after, we'll call you back after because you have to come right now. Thank you very much. God bless you all. If father speak, president speak, we can't have three speaking at the same time. But your talk is all talk. God bless you all. We have the eulogy right now. Come on, people, let's do the eulogy. Call in the family, we'll do the eulogy at this time. Amen. God bless you. Keep it straight and sweet. All right? Y'all don't know. When Cliff start, hey.
That's what you say. I can see Mr. Garcia laughing at that.
Be calling the family, calling the children to do the eulogy at this time. All those who are capable of standing and doing it, we call them to do the eulogy, all right?
So, hey. I don't know if I could stand here today and talk for about 5 hours. About
yeah, where is that again?
And you know, just in my hand.
That's the man said, you're proper. Like it, I go leg.
Yeah.
I didn't write anything. Right?
Yeah, tell him come.
Because I think pretty much.
Why is it so far? It should be so far. It should be
right here. I hear Mr. Huggins say he's a jack of all trades. My father was a stonemason, a builder, a laborer, laid tiles, foot windows, make shoes. He was a soldier. He was a cook, he was a baker, he was my first football coach, right, my first educator. He was a man that was proud to see how he had a part to play in the evolution of Diego Martin and many parts of Trinidad. And everybody know that I left here a long time ago, but it seems like I never leave because I'm always here, right? And I always come back to see my father and line with him. And many times I'll come for Carnival and I have big plans to, you know, meet with old friends and, you know, and I'll come here for 2 weeks and I ain't leave the gallery yet. Because we're just talking about things from years ago, sometimes the same stories over and over, but you know, repetition is good. So when you hear the same thing over and over, it stick, you know, something had to stick. And as I grew older, my dad taught me a lot of things about life. Because when you know, it was most times with us, he and I, for one reason or another. But I was able to, didn't know at the time what I was being taught until I became a big man. See him walking with the tools, work Monday to Friday.
When you talk on the
And in the summertime, as you say, you know, the school's out, I go in Carney, El Zicoro, St. Anne's, Crystal Stream, Tunapuna, Mafeking, all these places. and around big men, and I always find a little project to do. I wasn't good at it, you know, pounding nail wood, and he was the foreman, so nobody was could I really tell him what to do, and I was just around. But as Preston said, the conversations I heard as a youth, I didn't know how much it would have been needed when I get older. So when I, one of my favorite pastime for us to do when I come is to get in the car, we go down and get some fish on Carnage. And then one of your favorite stretch to drive on was St. Lucian Road. And you could tell me almost every house from KFC to Diego Martin Jr. set that he worked on. He built a stone wall here, worked on that house there, put on this here, did this here, did that. And that was his joy, you know? So one day, then he said, turn here. I say, okay. Reach by forward, going back by St. Anthony's Daylight. Make a left here. Okay. And he says, see that river? I build that river. I build that river. I build it from all the way up Crystal Stream coming down. I'm going to stop, and when the government didn't think money, politics change and thing, and work start back, and they bring it back because the people didn't know what they're doing. Because he could do the best, you know? So, and he struggled the river mouth, and he gave me the history as to why the river ended at a certain point, right? Why the work stopped and they moved forward. And it's because the water, when the tide get high, he told me water needs somewhere to go. So it would be, they had to stop the river, so when the tide come in, the water could spread out and have enough tide to raise, right? So I turned to him and I said, well, wait now. You're talking about all this work you do here, there, you build a river all over the place. As a big man, all right? I said, where you get time to make 9 churn? He just watched me laugh. He never gave my answer. Still waiting on it, you know? But that was the times that, you know, I don't want to take too much time from bothering them, but those are the things that I remember about my father. We talk 3 times a day. Call him when I get in the car. Call him at lunchtime. Call him after work. You know, sometimes we talk in the night again, 9 o'clock, 8:30. Very integral role in my life. He never wanted me to do the work that he did. He said, I'm working hard now so that all the daughter do this same thing. One of the strongest men I ever knew. Picking up boulders, you know, and you know, laying brick, laying stone. One of the last jobs he did was the St. Anne's River. There was flooding and debris was coming down, you know, and they had to build a trap. And they come with the plan, and he had the workmen there, but no material incoming. So they're there, and they, you know, but while the workmen there, and you want to send them home, he said, come on, or they'll leave 10, half past 10, or they can go home, quite another material, no work. He sit down there with a piece of paper, a tea, and a pencil, and he mapping out what he's supposed to do. So I thought, well, he was the man who drafted the job too. So then they send a young man now, right, to bring the plan and show them what they're doing, and he already had everything already laid out. He already knew what he needs to do, right? And how much material is needed. So when the young man came now, just out of school, the young man told them, well, this is the plan and this is what we're doing. He said, we ain't doing that. master, well, this is what they sent me, an IC engineer, they sent me to tell you what to do. He said, no, we ain't doing that. This is what we're doing. I have it already planned out. Just bring material, I'm a man. There we go. He and the man again had a little squabble. That time it's just three of us there. And long story short, he ended up having a few choice words for the young man. And telling me, don't know what you're talking about, or they learn thing by book, I'm gonna come here and tell me things. And he said, matter of fact, you call yourself an engineer, you far from the engine. Go from here, just bring material, I'm a man, there you go. And that was it. Right? So those are the stories I can remember of my father. I have plenty more. But I really miss him. I don't think it really hit me yet. But everybody, most people here, you know how to reach me.
And I'll call you back later.
Good day.
To talk about my father, it's not hard, it's very easy. Everybody knows him. He's a great guy. We're very happy to speak.
He done.
He taught me a lot of things in life. He started by teaching me time. Simple as that. He taught me time, how to read time. He taught me how to ride a bike. He taught me how to fix the wheels on a bike when it bends. He taught me a lot of different things. One time he said to me, if all the men was one man, what a great man would he be? I'm cutting my story short. He was a great man. Yes, he was. My brother was trying to explain something to you guys a while ago. He was already talking about the silk trap that he built in Barataria. He invented that. And other things he did for the Ministry of Works and Drainage. I don't want to take your time. I don't have much to say. He did a lot for me in life. God bless his soul.
Go ahead. You good?
Well, I know Grandpa all my years.
He was all old. In his latter years here, when I visit him, he decided he had this bucket list. He wanna go here, there, and everywhere. And I was like, okay, we're going. So he said, a long time, I ain't go fishing. I say, okay, I don't know how to fish. He said, you know, I never went to be going how much years. I say, okay. So my husband's family, they have a family trip every year. And 1 year, well, this year, I say, you going to Bago, you know? He said, what? Going to Bago? I say, yeah, you know, I want to go and try those fast ferries because long time was Trinidad and Tobago. But I never used the Spirit and the Express and things. That's like, all right, we'll go on the boats and whatever. Grandpa packed his bag probably 6 months in advance. I was like, what happened to you? We going to cry down in October. That's nothing I had to make
make sure of everything. You were passing price, man, you pick up a blow up bed. I said, but it's a blow up bed, it's a bed. Nah, I want my own bed, my own space. Then he wants, well, I need no sim trunks, you know? I need no sim trunks. I say, no, you don't need no sim trunks. Grandpa walked at 89 or 90. He walked up the ferry stairs for the first time. And he was so happy and so glad to do that. That little thing that I would take for granted. He was very happy. Reach on the boat, he decided I want to go on the lookout.
Tell me, tell me smoking. Tell me smoking.
Go on the lookout. Leave him there. He decided he find a friend. And he talked to this man for the whole 2.5 hours. They talk about all kind of things. He could tell me the man with the man living, the man family. I said, but well, you know him? He said, no, I just meet him. I said, okay. Then another time we went to Bagua and he said he never took an airplane. My friend was getting married and I said, you're going to Bagua? And he said, what? Again? I said, yeah, he goes, you know, everywhere my husband and I go, we pack up the car and we all go. Never left him behind to say, you know, he there. And he went in the airplane for the first time, and that's an hour of scene. Just because he walked up the stairs, he's like, tell the hostess, I can walk up here and you don't worry yourself, don't you ought to lift me up? I can walk up here by myself. And he walked up, and he sat down, he said, I take any window, eh? I said, all right, no problem. And he enjoyed that 15 minutes flight. And then he said, you want to go Grenada, girl? Yeah, okay. And again, my husband made way and we went over. And I said all that to say, all the bucket list, that all the things that he had that he wanted to do, he went to a sanctuary place, he never went. Went to picnic, he never went. The last in December to March, I went on vacation and he told me about the fishing. And that was a wild time about the fishing. And I just tell him, Mom, pack up your stuff, you're going for a drive. So he loved long drives. And took him to Toko. And he called Miss Carleen. He said, Carleen, send a caster a line for me. I'm going fishing. But he didn't know when he going fishing. So he had his thing sit down for months, right? Finally took him up to Toko and he trying to show me how to fish. And it just was a stick and he said, that's all right. You didn't catch no fish today, but at least you're a fisher of men. Because he will always incorporate God, incorporate the Bible in everything. So you say, you ain't catch no fish today, but don't worry yourself, you'll be fishers of men. And I would miss him daily because we had some real fun times in those 5 years. We had some good times, really, really good times. And even when he couldn't go nowhere again, we got COVID and he said, COVID free this old body, don't worry, sister. And I said, all right, you know. And when he couldn't go nowhere again, you know, I didn't want to risk him going out. And he said, you're doing all your thing by yourself. No. I said, I ain't doing nothing, you know. So I would miss my grandfather daily. I love him. I told him that all the time. We would have the differences because he's a Garcia and I'm a Garcia. So we always have our differences, but less than 5 minutes, 10 minutes, we make back up. And he says, darling, I'm sorry too. And we move on, you know. He was a great man. He taught me some stuff, and I hold on to it daily. Thank you very much.
If you're one of the 9, come quick. Or the 10.
Thank you for having me. I am Mr. Gaffer, Boca. I had another sister, but she passed away. Forgive me.
I didn't grow up around my dad. Because we're different mom. And my mom always tried to keep me from him because, you know, they had a difference at the end of the day. But everything everybody said, he was such a great father. Even though he was not around him, he always took time to come and look for us. I remember one time we had really long day and she couldn't manage it and she cut it off. And he came out of a closet because he said, why you touch my daughter here? You know, he didn't want to get cut, but, you know, I tell him, I said, gas, I think I don't really have enough in jail. You know, and I remember when he started to build his house. I used to come every day to help him put on plastic and thingy thing with the dirt and put on the foundation. I used to really like being around him with that, you know, and teach me to the weights. When I started lifting weights and stuff like that, a girl in school, she started wanted to bully me, and I said, guys, this girl just coming around me and say, Allison, no, do she nothing? And eventually she knocked you out. He stopped her from lifting weights because if he had to do that, then you know it's not safe to be doing it. And then when I told him I was going up on his lightweight, he was so excited that, you know, I took up that part of, you know, training and stuff like that. And I don't know how to make up, if, you know, how he go on, because we had so much of plans to come and look for him, and me and my son was coming to look for him. And when I found out that he had so weak.
It's a pleasant good afternoon to everyone. All right. I know this is a difficult time for everyone and in the world right now, but I'm the middle kid. I'm the middle son. And I left here when I was pretty young. All right. And sometimes, you know, when you're apart from your family, you feel lonely. And I was different. I was really different because everywhere I step and walk, I remember his words. Don't be afraid. And we should never be afraid of anything. Because in life, we have to be confident about ourselves in order to move forward. And if you don't have that, you have to find it somehow. Because where there's a will, there's a way. All right? And I can tell you something about my dad. He was a teacher, educator, and a builder. Okay? And those three pillars, exactly what we need in our lives right now, especially in these times. Okay? So, with that said, he's gone. Okay? He's gone. But he's going to be still with each and every one of us here because he touched. I can press them like a brother. All right? He touched every single person. And every person's house here, he walked in or built. So that's something that we're going to remember for the rest of our life. Okay? And, you know, my dad was strong. Very strong. And to do the things that he did, in the time that he did it, he still didn't even have enough time. But he still did what he had to do. And that's all we need to do sometimes. So we gotta look to the skies and look to our left and our right and what's ahead of us. Okay? Because we have a saying. Alright? I won't take up too much time because I can real talk. Just like him. Alright? When we drive our cars, alright? There's a rearview mirror. Okay? And if you keep looking in the rearview mirror in life, you not make it. Whatever's ahead of us. Because if you keep looking in the rearview mirror, what's gonna happen? You're going to run into somebody because you're not paying attention. So in life, if you pay attention to the things and the signs that's given to you, you'll make it. You'll make it. So, today, and moving forward, we all have to come together as one and on one accord so that we can be prosperous and help each other. Helping is a very important thing that we need to do because it can come 360 and full circle. So, we just have to keep pushing and keep pressing. All right? For me, I was a footballer. All right? I played football day and night. And sometimes he used to beat me because I stayed out too late. And this guy over here. All right? And it helped me. It helped me. It helped me along the way because I never gave up. I never gave up. And, you know, he would call me every day. Sometimes if he don't get me, he would call Ricardo. Ricardo, you talk to Sean? Ricardo say no. Ricardo would call me, say, guys call, we want to talk to you. Call him back twice a day. Okay, and when we come to visit, I surprised him one time. I didn't even tell him I was coming. And I showed up in the gallery, and he started crying. He was like, Melton? Shelton? I said, no, I'm Sean. And he just started crying. And I come up and I drop the suitcases and I say, I reach way after me. He said, I actually big pop in the back, we go make some fish ball. And that's how he was. Because he was given, caring, understanding. And for all my brothers and my sisters, okay, it's us now. And we're not against the world. It's us. All right? So we're going to make it. We're going to make it. And there's another thing, too. And, you know, everybody can talk and say everything, good, bad, indifferent. But if it wasn't for my mother, we wouldn't have been here today. So blessings to my mother as well.
Sure.
Okay? And they both would want to see us live well, do well, and help each other because that's a blessing as well too for every one of us. Okay? So we have to keep doing what we do right now and make sure that we embrace this part of life because it's life. Okay? We live and we die. Okay, so we should not, you know, hold this against us right now. It's something that we can do to move forward and be better as a family, right? As a family. So, you know, I'm happy that everyone's here and who I haven't seen in years and I grew up with, and it's a blessing. This is a blessing. So with my dad being laid to rest, okay, we, my family and my brothers and sisters, we are the ones that's going to work for him now because he showed us the path. So we got to walk through the path right now and get to where we need to go to. And it's very important that we do that right now because the road to life has a lot of roadblocks, a lot of stoppages, a lot of stop signs, okay? But we're on a mission. We're on a mission. And the mission is to get to where we need to go to. So sometimes we might have to deviate and divert from different things, but we'll still get to where we need to go to. And that would make a lot of people stronger and better in this world today. So we have to unite. We have to unite and be thankful, and most of all, be humble. Yeah. That's the most important thing. We have to be humble.
Because if you're not humble, it gives your soul and body ignorance to everything. So that's some of the things that we have to pay attention to. So although it hasn't hit me yet. Okay? But I try to be strong, not only for myself, but for my family and my kids and my brothers. That's why I have to be the inspiration for my brothers who are falling short. Because everybody needs a second chance, okay? But you only have one chance to make a first impression, okay? So we have to keep pushing. We have to do better. And as a family, I think we're on the right path, because with all the encyclopedias and everything that we had in the bookshelf, I take heed to that, because I was books and sports, that's me. And I put that into perspective now, because it made me a whole lot stronger for the things that I'm doing right now. And I work just like him, 7 days a week, 24 hours. I have 3 cell phones, and they ring nonstop. And that's what I do, because I love helping people as well. I was never a crafty child. Never was good with my hands. But here, I got that. But my rest of brothers, they're the ones who helped me along the way. They would show me stuff. Melvin and Shelton, Ricardo, they would show me stuff. You know? And that's what brothers are for, and sisters. Okay, we lean on each other when the other one falls short. So now, that's what we have to do as a family. And we haven't been together or close in proximity, although we're social distancing, you know, but it's going to bring us a little closer, you know. So I want to thank everyone for being here on this special day, so that we can live on. We can live on. Without a doubt. All right, so I want to thank everybody again, and Mr. Peter George, all right? Always talk to him as another father, and he helped me a lot, So thank you again, and you know, let's get this passion of a great man, and you know, do the things that would build us as people and as human beings. Because we all can take a piece of what he gave. Not only his kids, everyone here. So, and we talked about it. So let's put it into action, put it into movement. All right? So thank you, everyone. Appreciate it.
One of the things I appreciate this afternoon is that because you all don't go to church normally during the coronavirus, I thank God for Mr. Garcia Parsons, so you can stay in church all day. It's only because of him we are in church this morning. Had it been for him, amen. We ain't seen you at talk in church. We can invite, we can do whatever we want. You will not be there. You say corona. And today, because Mr. Garcia, you are here. However, I'm going to share with you a simple topic. And I like the ending of it. On a journey that you have to take, we all have to take. And John, look at it from a different perspective, but we all get the glimpse of it as we go along. So in Revelation chapter 21, and reading from verse 1, just a few verses. For those of you who don't have a Bible, I know your Bible on your cell phone, so you can turn with me. And if you get a call, let it be from heaven. If it's from hell, leave it. If it's from heaven, take it. Now, Revelation chapter 21, verse 1. Now I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and there was no more sea. Then I, John, saw it. Take note of who's seen it. John said, I saw a holy city, a new Jerusalem coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from heaven saying, so these two things we recognize. He saw and he heard. Heard a loud voice from heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people. God himself will be with them and be their God. And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, no sorrow, nor crying. There shall be no more pain, for the former things have passed away.
Then he who sat on the throne said, "Behold, I make all things new." And he said to me, "Write, for these works are true and faithful." And he said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give of the fountain of the water of life freely to him who thirsts. He who overcomes shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son." For the word is blessed. Many talk already have passed on. I will be short. I would like to keep you all gone because I think the food is still cooking. She ain't finished cooking as yet. So because she's cooking, I'm still preaching. I know you'll be hungry right after for the repast. So I'm going to keep preaching until she finishes cooking. When you finish cooking, give me the signal up there. All right? Yes, young lady? When you finish cooking, give me the signal. John the Revelator. He had a vision from God. And if there's one person that we need to have a vision from, it's God. Sometimes men give vision and it's not clear. But when God gives us a vision, it is very clear. And what John saw, he saw something coming down from heaven. The Bible tells us he saw a new heaven and a new earth. For this that we are on presently, it is cursed. It's not cursed because we are here. It's cursed because of one man caused it to be cursed. And the man that caused it to be cursed is not even around to recognize the problem that he has left for us. The person who caused the earth to be cursed is Adam. Because of you, earth is cursed. If you don't believe me, Genesis chapter 3 and verse 17, you'll see it right there. He cursed the earth because of Adam failed to repent. Failed to tell his wife where she was going wrong. And may I say to men, whenever your wife is going wrong, talk to her. It's either you are a man or you are a manicure. But if you're a real man in your home, when your wife is going wrong, you need to talk to her. Why? Because she needs to be redirected on the right path to life.
Amen.
Get over that part. Don't say preacher. That's not for us who here. So John and the Revelator. What he saw something coming down. There was a vision that God gave him, and he saw it coming down from heaven. And he saw it coming down to earth. And the person who gives the vision to us is God. The reason why I am in the position that I am is not because of my mother, it's not because of my father, it's not because my sister is doing a great work in the community. It is because of God. The reason why we are here today is not only because of Mr. Garcia, it's because we are alive, and it's because of God. We could have been somewhere else doing something else, but the reason why we are here, it is because of God. If I were you, I'd put my hands together for the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. The reason why I'm surviving, the Bible is in him we live and in him we move and in him we have our being. Nothing else exists but God. We all exist because of God.
Amen.
The reason why Mr. Garcia has lived so long is because of God.
Come on now.
The reason why he was able to impart knowledge to many of us is because that God gave it to him.
Come on, preach it.
And I discovered in his life he wasn't a selfish person. Amen. Selfish person trying to keep everything to themselves.
Yeah, come on.
But his lifestyle, the things that he inculcated probably from his former parents before, or those who made an impact in his life, he decided, I must pass this on. Yeah. Something that is important, as the young man said earlier on in the community, that what he passed on to us is knowledge.
Come on.
And one of the things that we need in this community, we need knowledge.
Yes, sir.
If people are knowledgeable of things, their life will change.
Come on now,
if people are knowledgeable of things, your society will be different. If people are knowledgeable of things, our world will be different.
Come on now, preach.
And one thing he passed on to many of us, if he can give my sister a concordance, what else he can give to somebody else? Just a mere phone call to encourage somebody. That is important. You don't know, sometimes somebody might be depressed. They might be downtrodden, they might be beat up, they might be an abuser. And Mr. Garcia call you and say, how are you doing today? That will encourage somebody in life.
Amen. Amen.
just need somebody to encourage you. Sometimes you are discouraged by the surroundings.
Yeah.
And sometimes I can be discouraged and displeased by the things that are happening in our community. And what I'm going to say earlier, when I say it now, because I have the microphone, I can talk right now. None of us here, and especially the young people in the community, they didn't light up for ambulance for Mr. Garcia the way they light up for somebody else. Why would them brighten up this community right here for Mr. Garcia, who have 92 years, the way we did it for somebody else in the community? She'll like it up for Mr. Garcia. Why? Because he leave a legacy for all of us to follow. But a young man, apparently, whatever happened in the past, we come and brighten up the air. Everybody was outside. But when it comes to Mr. Garcia, we inside and we hide them because of Corona. The same time that Corona going around, and everybody was out here. And I was shocked because I was wondering, why is there all these flambos for this young man? Mr. Garcia will live 92 years. Where he'll live and next to where he is living. We gotta beg people to come and have a service. That is an indictment to all of you. Take note. I'm a serious person when it comes to the microphone and when it comes to the pulpit. I've seen it all around us. And we have to be more careful and give people their due reward. A man lived for 92 years and impacted many lives. Not only elderly people, but he was a man who was in touch with young people. Hey, we should put our hands together for his granddaughter. Let me tell you this, sir. I've come to realize that young people put old people in homes and they don't have anything to do with them.
Right.
But here there's a family in spite of as a grand. Take up their grandfather. Walk with him. Wherever she's going, he is there. Whether it's Tobago, he is there. Whether it's Toko, he is there. Doesn't matter the situation. If she'll pick him up and carry him, he is there.
Yes, sir. Come on now. Preach it.
Could you imagine? What a blessing like that to have a granddaughter. Somebody that'll take your pension and put it in a home and say, take care of you. And they come and visit you every now and then. But when it comes to young people taking care of your grandparents, my God, that is a blessing in disguise. You ministered right away. There's a blessing coming your way, my sister and her husband. They did all that they can for their grandfather. That is a blessing. I'm saying to Russia, don't put your mother and your father in a home when they're getting old, because when you were young, they take care of you. When you were young and they didn't know better, they were taking care of you. Don't wait until you get old to put you in a home and let somebody just rain upon you and you're drinking yourself and you don't know what to do. Why? Because they took care of you when you were young.
That's right, Richard.
They took care of you. So don't just put them in a home and let them pass the time by. It's sad to see when we do these things. I've been to home for the elderly, and I'm knocking home for the elderly. It's important sometimes because some people choose to go there. But I'm saying because of the life that he lived and what they have done for him, that is a blessing. So John the Revelator, he had a vision. And he saw something from God. What he saw was what we are in will pass away. This heaven and this earth will pass away. And he saw God coming down in the tabernacle. Why God came down? Because God wants to have a relationship with men.
Yes.
I'm saying to us this morning, God wants to have a relationship with you and I. Doesn't matter the church that you are going into. Once you have a relationship with God, that is important. That's why I love the song service. I love all the testimonies. We must have a relationship with God in this season. Why? Because people are dying like dogs every day. You hear the rate of the coronavirus that's taking place in our country. People are dying every minute. And we need to know where we are going. So John, give us a glimpse of what is to take place. Can you talk about a new heaven? A place whereby time is no more. Talking about a new earth. Just imagine the heaven that he's speaking about. A place that is glorious. A place that is magnificent. Just picture for a moment. What can a heaven
whatever that he is speaking about. A praise that is grandeur. Words can't even express what John sees with his 2x4 mind. Because he is finite, and God who's given him this vision is infinite. Just imagine that for a moment. This man who is finite, trying to picture what God is showing him, download in the spirit to tell us that there is a place for all of us to be prepared to go sometime in the future. If you're not prepared to go there, prepare to be like the rich man. Prepare to make him a bed in hell. Life is real. And death is real. So John, when he saw this, a new heaven and a new earth. And after he saw the tabernacle coming on dull with men. And he said, God himself. I thank God that he is God. I thank God that he is God. Amen. The Bible says that God himself, not man.
Come on now.
God himself. This rod that I have might be able to dry somebody's tears. But all men who are crying, this is not enough.
Come on.
You know why? Because this is a small thing. But for the great, the almighty, the one who's omnipotent and omniscient, when he come and he wipe away your tear, you won't cry anymore. When God say he will wipe away all tears, my brothers and sisters, he has the ability. And I thank God that if he said it, it will come to pass. Why? Because he is God. He's not a man that he should lie, nor any person that he should repent. God is God, and he's God all by himself. So if he said he will wipe away all our tears, there is a place whereby there will be no more crying there.
Come on.
So God is in a better place. Hey, if he cried when he came, he will cry again. He will be glad to see you. There will be no more pain. The place where you're going to, there will be no more pain.
Come on now.
The new heaven and new earth, there will be no more pain. You have to worry yourself about what you are going through now. Like one doctor told a friend of mine, he said, pain is just a gentle reminder to tell you that there is a God. When we're going through pain, just to remind us that there is a God. Why? Because sometimes the only time we know God is when we are in
pain.
Help me preach it. The only time we recognize God is when we are in pain. If there's no pain, we live our life and do anything we want. Go about our lives, we hurt people, we don't care whether we hurt them or we bless them. We don't care whether we abuse or we misuse or we mistreat them, we don't care. But when there's pain, when there's trouble, when something happens that is real, doesn't matter who it is, when there's real pain, you know the pastor, though. But when there's pain, you know the teacher. You know who to call.
Jesus.
You know the priest. When there's pain. But say there's no pain. Hey, corona, no corona.
Yeah.
I was telling a good friend of mine this morning. This is off the topic. I cannot understand how young men, father, I cannot understand in the midst of coronavirus. I cannot understand my 2x4 mind. I cannot understand young men can share a hem inside my corona. They share a hem which costs a dollar. A man can buy a hem just walk by himself. A man sharing a hem. I say, I'm not thinking about social media. I said the young man, are we making love over a hem? Because we buy him anymore and he kiss up. And you're passing that up to the next person. You might be sucking a man's tongue and you're smoking a hem. A hem. Come back to that scene. Preston, keep on the topic. Say it right. And Preston, say the topic. A hem, a man sharing a hem. A hem. Imagine a man sharing a hem and being coronavirus. A hem. A hem costs a dollar. Man. God help us. So he said there'll be no more crying. Verse 4. He wiped away our tears. There shall be no more death. The thing I love about this scripture is that there shall be no more. Even though there is death now, there comes a time in life that John the Revelator saw. He said, there'll be no more. If there's one thing I can take from this afternoon, there will be no more. No more virus to talk about.
Come on now.
When Mr. Garcia is concerned. No more vaccination or third booster.
Come on now.
There's no more pain.
Come on.
Just imagine you're going through life. And there comes a time in your life where there'll be no more.
Come on.
No more heartache. No more phone call. No more WhatsApp. There'll be no more. Why? Because the place where we are going, there will be peace.
Come on.
There will be joy. In order to get there, you had to be a child of God. You had to be prepared to get there. As much as you didn't catch a fish, you will be fishers of men. That is a word.
Amen.
For the wise, that is sufficient. No more sorrow. Be going through sorrow is a hell of a thing. He said there'll be no more sorrow and there'll be no more pain. Can you imagine him going through his time, going through his ordeal? I can imagine when he used to wear his katka and he had been going through the painful experience of placing it right where it ought to be. But where he is now, there is no more pain in life. For him, his life is changed. The Bible tells us that this mortal shall put on immortality. There is a change that is coming for all of us. And the only how we're going to experience that change is when we all die. This corruptible shall put on incorruption. In the twinkling of an eye, we all shall be changed. Why? Because if God said it, it shall come to pass, saints. Don't give up on God in this season. I want to remind you all as much as possible, serve God, serve God, serve God. During this time, you have to persevere.
Amen.
You must persevere. In order for us to make it, we must persevere. We must have patience. One of the criteria in life. In order for us to make it, we must persevere. We must have patience. And as Mr. Garcia was, he was a people's person. Don't live a life selfish. He was a people's person. I close with this. Even as John the Revelator saw the new heaven, new earth, tabernacle of God, no more pain and all these different things, I've come to realize as I close, and this is the most painful part in a funeral service for me, for the years I've been doing funeral services, I've discovered that death is personal. One of the things I've discovered that death is personal. Why I'm saying that? Because a person who dies is Mr. Garcia alone. Mm. It remains personal.
Mm-hmm.
That won't change.
Come on.
It remains personal. This is very, very sad, but that's the reality of it. Whether he's buried or burned, whatever they do with the body, it turned to ashes or the dust returned to the dust, we discover that it remains there permanently. So while death is personal and it's remained there permanently, there's also another thing that I've discovered about death. Is that to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. And him being absent, the real person and fly out already. That's why we sing the song, I'll fly to glory. To be present with the Lord. And in order for us to get to the last one, he said, I've gone to prepare a place for you. Where I am, you may be also. You must be prepared. You can't get on the other side unless you are prepared to go there. So Garcia couldn't go to Bago unless he was prepared
mm-hmm.
to go there.
Mm-hmm.
He couldn't go fishing unless he was prepared
mm-hmm.
to go there.
Mm-hmm.
And the thing about it, there was transportation. There was a vehicle that was there to carry him on the other side of where he was going. There was a vehicle.
I'm saying to us, there's a vehicle for all of us to be transported on the other side. The vehicle is Jesus Christ. Amen. We all need that vehicle.
Amen.
But when we get on the other side, we can all say what a wonderful place it will be. It will be wonderful. But we must choose the vehicle. Sometimes a vehicle can be parked on the side of the road and we pass it straight. Mm-hmm. We can hear about a vehicle and pay no attention.
Yeah, sure.
The vehicle come to us, offer us a drop, and we say, no, I don't want it. I'm waiting for the next one. And sometimes the next vehicle we take, we make it in our destination because the vehicle could get in an accident. I'm saying to us, if you take the wrong vehicle, you could end up in the wrong place. But if you have the right vehicle,
come on.
You could take you to the right destination.
Come on now, Bishop.
And the vehicle that we need to take is Jesus.
Amen.
Don't let Jesus, don't let this moment pass you by.
That's right.
As much as we can talk and sing and shout and look back at his life and the legacy of him and all these different things, they are good, but what about us who remain? We must be prepared. And I'm telling you, like it is, my cousin-in-law, when I heard about him, he was good, and next minute, he gone. We heard about a young nurse who was in the hospital from Dick Martin, and as good as she was, she's gone. My good friend, even though he served God for a long period of time, as good as he was, something still came and took him out, but he's gone. And even though Mr. Garcia lived to 92, and John Butter, remember, wife lived to 106, they all gone. You and I had to prepare them and make sure that we get on the other side because life is short. We must be prepared. As much as possible, it is short and we must be prepared. So as I close, we want to pray for the sons, daughter, granddaughter, I want to pray for them this morning that God will continue to strengthen them. The passing of a loved one is not an easy thing, trust me. I tell people and they can identify that I lost my mother, I lost my father, so it's not a strange thing for her to come and do this, because I lost my mother and I lost my father already. And they also have lost their parents. We lost two brothers and a sister. And to stand and do a funeral over your family, it takes the grace of God and the grace of God and nothing else. So when they called me to do this one, I was like, I don't know why people have called me to do funeral in the community. But I thank God they called me because I'm praying that all of you all die so I don't know live. God bless you. Let us pray for the family.
Oh my God.
I don't know why they just called me. I heard somebody say, when I die, I want you to do the funeral. I want to know, you know you're going to die before me. I they said, Mr. Garcia, watch highest funeral from on his seat.
Yeah.
Start right here. And he said, I want it just so. That might be out there, you know, your son. Mm. Because he's so highest. He said, I want it just so.
Mm.
And I say, you want us to do it? I say, you call me again? So, oh, please don't call me. Don't call me. Let's pray for the family. Let's call the family together. Let's pray for them. Come, family, come quick. Family of Mr. Garcia, come quick. If you know yourself, if you don't belong to Mr. Garcia, stay in the peripheral. But if you belong to Mr. Garcia, come quick. The family of Mr. Garcia, please come quick so we can pray for you all.
See,
that's what they are sick breaking the ears. Call the brothers and then I'll let them know. I'm calling them. So they're here.
They're here.
I don't know if they're here.
They're
okay. Mr. Garcia was a fast mover. So who was fast, Mr. Garcia's move? One of the things I could recall that in his latter years that nobody mentioned, as much as they say he was a teacher and he was a builder and all kinds of different things, and I think was this one said he was very meticulous, and I said, mention Mr. Garcia's a billboard cage. Nobody mentioned that.
that man should take time. I don't know how that man should take some thing and drill a fine hole, drill through those pieces of wood, and build a bird cage. I mean, one of the neatest bird cage you could ever find. It's a Garcia building.
Make him pay for it, huh? It's very expensive.
Yeah, they talk about that.
So I want to see what they said. I just want to see what they didn't say. All right, so, but if you want to see, come and see it too. You know, all right, so we thank God for the family who are present us. Let us pray, let us pray, let us pray. Oh Father and oh God, we lift, oh God, this children, grant. And if they are any great, we lift them also before you. And we give thanks, oh God, for his children, grandchildren, great-grand, if there are any. And whosoever they are, remain, we give thanks for them. And those who are even absent, God, we still give thanks for them. And we pray, oh dear God, even though they go through a time of grief, your word said to us that you will wipe away all our tears. And we know, God, this might be emotional for some. While some trying to be strong, while some still trying to God to understand what they are dealing with, you are the God of all comfort. God, you are dear, oh God, for Lazarus' sisters. When Lazarus, oh God, your brother passed away. And I pray, oh dear God, that you will be there for them. Give them, oh God, the strength that they need. Give them, oh God, the peace. Give them, oh God, the grace, oh God, to run this race. Cause them, oh God, to be faithful, oh God, like never before. Bind them, oh God, with cords that cannot be broken. I pray, oh God, that whenever, oh God, they leave, oh God, these shores and those who will remain, give them, oh God, journeying mercies. That whenever they come again, oh God, they will unite, oh God, in harmony. Let there be no, oh God, friction among them, oh God, in the passing of their father, grandfather, loved one. We pray, oh God, let there be harmony, oh God, from the head, oh God, to the very youngest, oh God. We pray, oh God, for harmony amongst them. Yes. Strengthen where needs to be strengthened. Yes. Where, oh God, they are failed in thoughts, word, and deed, we pray, oh God, that they wash, you will cleanse, you will purify, you will make whole again. Forgive, oh God, have mercy, oh God, upon them. Cause them, oh God, to be like arrows, oh God, to be shoot. As Mr. Garcia has left a legacy for them to follow, for many of us in the community to follow. So we thank you, God, for them. We thank you, God, for everyone that come out today. We thank you for all those who in their homes, oh dear God, are looking on, oh God, from their homes, all those who are on social media. God, we give thanks and we give praise. And we pray, oh dear God, that you have your perfect way in our midst, in Jesus' name. Let all the God say amen.
Amen.
Thank you very much. God bless you.
Yes.
Hallelujah. At this time,
tell by the people that they could sign the scripture, right?
Okay. Again, I just obedient child. They said you can sign the big picture, right there. The big picture, you can sign it. At this time, what I want to do, because the services today, we be living in America, right? We have service today and burial tomorrow. So we are in America. You know what I'm saying? We're in America, right? So, right. Because all children come to America, so we're in America. So, service tonight, burial tomorrow. So, they're going to have a cremation tomorrow. So, what are you going to do? You're going to pronounce it from now. Do the final rites from now. And after that, you can take time to sign the picture. Have you in, continue to wear a mask, social distance. And I think by now, I can say, now the food is almost done. We want to thank God for Danny's funeral home. If you're looking for a funeral home for your loved one, choose Danny's, because I work for them. Yeah. I work for Danny's only for funeral though. You know, when it doesn't have a pastor, when it don't have a pastor.
I don't work for Denise. Or be clear, I don't work for Denise. All right? I'm just saying that. But again, truly. So we're going to do the final rites here. Rites of the living to the departed, as we say, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. In committing this body to the grave, the dust returns to the earth as it was. The spirit has gone to God who gave it. I heard a voice from heaven saying, write, blessed are the dead which died in the Lord from henceforth ye, said the spirit, that they may rest from their labors, for their works do follow with them. For them that sleep in Jesus shall God bring with him, and over such a second death hath no power. May I say, we brought nothing to this world. And even though he built houses, he built rivers, he built lives, there's a certain thing we carry nothing out. We have discovered that the Lord give, and the Lord hath taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible. And we shall be changed, for this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall put on incorruption, and this mortal shall put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where's thy sting? O grave, where's thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the Lord. But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved, be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as you know, your labor is not in vain. Was as pleasant unto himself, our beloved Mr. Thomas Garcia. We therefore commit his body again to the ground, looking for the blessed hope and the glorious appearing of the great God and our Savior, Jesus Christ, who shall change the body of our humiliation and fashion it anew in the likeness of his own body, according to the working of his mighty power, wherewith he is able even to subdue all things unto himself. May I say now, the God of peace that brought again from the dead our beloved, our Lord Jesus Christ, that great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in his sight. Through Jesus Christ, to whom all glory, honor, and power belongs forever and ever. Amen. May I say, the Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. The Lord cause his face to shine upon you and give you his peace. In Jesus' name. Have a great afternoon, people. God bless you all. Good to see you, my friend, on the bike. Good to see you. Come again.
Could just make a quick announcement for persons who vehicles park in front of the house to bring the cars in the tank here, please.
Okay, all those who park and go in front of the house, please, there's free parking in the tank yard, so you can remove your vehicle down to the tank yard, because they want to have to repass on that side. They can come and sign, and we have the viewing of the body. God bless you. Have a great afternoon. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.
Ambro. Done.
juice at this thing, it's a part of the picture. When the
I am taking the air.
I'm Good day, everyone. My name is Chris. I'm your panel director for the day. What we are about to do is something special, right? From your heart. Just remember all the good times, you know, all the times he have, you know, comfort you all in a hard time, and just let it out from your heart, you know. All ready? One, two, three. May your soul rest in peace.
When I die, hallelujah, when I die,
I'm going to go to the next one.
my face, the final curtain. My friend, I'll say it clear, I'll state my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full. I traveled each and every highway and more, much more than this. I did it my way. Regrets, I've had a few, but then again, too few to mention. I did what I had to do, and saw it through without exemption. I planned each charted course, each careful step along the byway, and more, much more than this. I did it my way. Yes, there were times, I'm sure you knew, when I bit off more than I could chew. But through it all, when there was doubt, I ate it up and spit it out. I faced it all and I stood tall and did it my way. I've loved, I've laughed and cried, I've had my fill, my share of losing, and now as tears subside, I find it all so amusing to think I did all that. And may I say, not in a shy way, oh no, oh no, not me, I did it my way. For what is a man, what has he got, if not himself, then he has not to say the things he truly.
I've lived a life that's full. do